Hey folks, Dave Ashenbrenner here, and I'm here to answer all of your questions about the AR3. First of all, what is an AR3 and what makes it different from any other recumbent out there, any other Tadpole recumbent? All right, as promised, we're going to look at both of these recumbents, the AR3 over here, and this is a typical steering system configuration on your typical Tadpole recumbent. And here's how it works. This is basically how an automobile steering system is set up. It's got what they call kingpins, and the pivots ride on these kingpins right here. And they're joined together or tied together, hence the word tie rod, with this tie rod. And the tie rod operates both of them at the same time. Now the configuration of this type of steering depends upon a formula called Ackerman steering. And what that means is these wheels, let's say, are 30 inches apart. And when you turn it, both wheels should be rotating around the radius of the way that this wheel is pointed. So let's just say 10 feet from here, this axle is pointed over there. This axle should be pointed the same way, but these tires are not parallel to each other. The tire in the front is probably an inch further over here than it is over here, and that's so that it maintains that equal radius around that corner. And that's quite a formula. And actually, you see I patched the tie rod here and put these scab plates on here because this did not have an accurate Ackerman steering. So I figured out the geometry on it and put the Ackerman in it to get it to steer better. And the reason I did that was I was having a lot of problem with what I call twitch. You can see what small amount of movement on the handlebars will deviate the direction of the steering. And it's real hard when you're on a recumbent, or I find it hard on a standard recumbent, to maintain, while I'm trying to pedal, I'm trying to maintain a straight line with this. And there are some recumbents, I've got to say, that have a linkage that links up to this that gives you a little more leverage on this. But just remember that your leverage is between the top of this handlebar and this top of this kingpin right here. That's the amount of leverage you have. It's about maybe 14 inches here, by the way the crow flies. So we're going to take a look at this and we're going to compare this to the AR3 steering. Okay, so here's the AR3 steering, and what you're going to notice is the linkage the leverage between where you're holding onto it, between here and here, is your leverage. So you get a little advantage of the leverage on that, and you have both hands, one's pushing and one's pulling on it. You're not using the tiller like this. Your muscles aren't as strong this way as they are your push and pull. So you're using this type of action when you're steering the AR3, plus your lean is helping that. And that's the difference between the two types of steering. Now, these wheels, the kingpins, are right here on the AR3. The kingpins run horizontally instead of vertically on the AR3. And these kingpins were welded into position. It's actually in the design. These wheels are absolutely perfectly parallel all the way through the turn. And if you understand a little bit about geometry, right now, these wheels are both following, by nature, their own radius. So in other words, if I strung between here and that imaginary 10-foot mark, say if we're on a 10-foot radius, if I strung up a straight line between here and that radius right there, this would be following that radius, this would be following its own radius just by nature. They don't have to compensate to do that. And the advantage that you get from that is no wheel scrub in the corners. These wheels will go right around the corners, and as you corner, you will not hear, not even a whisper come from the front wheels. In contrast, the typical Recumbent, I can hear noise from the front wheels. They call it scrubbing, because both of the tires aren't following their exact radius properly. So that's one nice thing about the steering on this. The other thing is, this has a steering dampener on it. This will stabilize, that's this part here. There's a built-in clutch below this knob, and you hand tighten this knob down to suit your situation, and it holds it with what they call stiction. You overcome it very easily, but it keeps you from oscillating when you're pedaling, so you don't have that oscillation in your steering. And it's all adjustable. You can tighten it down even more if you want, but it helps, it aids when you're getting on and off the bike. It holds the bike into a certain position while you're getting on, and it doesn't flop over to one side or the other. Makes it just a little bit easier. But that's the difference in the steering systems on these. The front wheel lean factor is governed by these horizontal kingpins right here, by these tie rods. You see what the tie rod does? Pushes out on the outside wheel, and it pulls in on the inner wheel while you're going around your corner. And this really helps keep that bicycle-like handling around corners. It also pulls this inside wheel in at the bottom and pushes the outside wheel out, which increases the track between the center of the frame and the bottom of the wheel. So in essence, it's working somewhat like an outrigger would on a boat. And it really has a stabilizing feeling. I'll see Recumbent videos where people will get them up on two wheels and ride them like a chitwood car. And that's a little scary to me, because that just means it's unstable in a corner. You could flip it over. This one, I've taking it around some really sharp corners, and being my own crash test dummy, I've gone as fast as I dare go around corners, and it's just, I can't flip it. It's very stable at high speed. But that's the difference between the steering on the AR3, unlike anything else. Well, folks, thanks for coming out to my shop and allowing me to explain the AR3 versus the typical Recumbent steering system. I hope this helps you understand how the AR3 works and how the steering works on it. If anybody has any questions, please leave a note for me below. I'll answer you as soon as I can. We'll see you next time.